I believe that has, yeah, I've got something similar as well. I've it's an error, and I believe it's getting fixed today or tomorrow or something, because there's just been a new update put out with the workshop fixing it. So now anyone who couldn't upload scenarios now can. If this is the problem, if you were stuck on the where it said validating. Right, good afternoon. As you've noticed, you're driving an unusual consist setup today. The usual locomotive is broken down with limited rolling stock available at the depot. This BR155 freight loco was the best we could find. It's a rainy autumn, so I'm sure passengers don't care about what type of loco picks them up. Get them to Starnberg safely, stopping at all stations along the way. Press T to allow passengers to board here at Garmisch-Partenkirchen. Press Tab to request permission to pass a signal ahead. Lights, instrument lights, BZB, CIFA, U. Right, that's better. Switch it back to that mode. A little bit down. Excellent! No on-screen chat isn't working, is it? I bet followers and things aren't working either. Twitch alerts is broke. GG Twitch alerts. That means no followers, so I'll call them out manually. No followers and nothing else, so I'm going to have to call them out manually. I do apologise for that. That's out of my control. Right, have we got access? Hey, look at that. We've got access. That's down there. That's there. What's our lighting situation? We have the correct lights, we have wipers. Superb! Hey there, Rubku. Welcome. Oh, you're still live, Rubku. Oh, Brandon Redboy. Last time you watched the stream was when your mum was diagnosed with cancer. She's now had the op and having chemo in a few weeks. Well, best of luck. I hope everything is going well. There you go. I've just turned the... there you go. Hopefully that's got rid of all the erroneous messages. Right, we are clear to go through. Well, no, I've just checked and it is to actually... Oh, CIFA's working. Excellent. It is actually Twitch alerts that have got a problem. That I can't enter auth tokens. That's down to Twitch alerts to do that. Unless I have to re-log in to Twitch alerts. I might try that actually. Let's wait for this scenario to finish. And that was a green light, wasn't it? I'm sure it was. So I'm going to end from monitoring and just get a move on. I love driving this. In case you hadn't noticed, I really like driving this train. Limit. How do I get 60 FPS that smooth? I'm getting 57 at the moment, but I'm using a two stream setup at the moment, Oblivious. The game's smooth right out when I use the two stream setup. So a two PC, sorry. So I've got another PC with an Elgato capture card in it that's actually doing all the capturing and taking that off this machine and everything else off this machine. It's made a tremendous difference to the performance. I have at the moment got the detail settings turned, the scenery quality turned down a bit. Really all that affects is memory usage. It does affect the visuals a bit, but mostly it affects memory usage. And that's because people keep giving me scenarios that need, you know, 64-bit games to work, which this isn't. Right. So one thing I want to talk to you guys, since we've got quite a lengthy scenario here, let's have a chat. I want to have a look at, I don't know if you guys have seen, there's a trend at the moment for these things called loyalty bots. What they do is every minute you're on the stream, they give you some, they give you a point of some sort, whether it's a coin or a ticket or a token or a credit. So every minute you get one of these things. And then the idea is that you can spend those on various things. Some of them are gambling games where you can win more or lose more, and some of them have got little rewards like getting a shout out on the stream, for example, or something like that. So I've been having a read, because initially I couldn't really see the point, I'm reading into it more, looking at some of the what the bigger streamers are doing and how they're managing it. It kind of sees I'm keen on seeing the point. I'm really seeing the point. It seems like a really good idea. Oblivious, no, it won't crash on mine. I've got the fix, so my game will run perfectly, he says. Fingers crossed it won't crash. It won't crash for that reason, because I've got the fix that's in QA at the moment on this machine. So yeah, so I'm having a look at this idea of putting a loyalty bot in, and you know, it'd be something like you watch the stream, you get some tokens, and maybe some of the things. It'll be what can you do with those? I'm going to call them. Let's call them tickets for the sake of argument. Seems a bit transporty. What can you do with them? And it's what kind of things would you want to spend those tickets on? I'm thinking, for example, people want to send some screenshots into the game. What would they? Just realised I'm waffling. I'm not planning on stopping. if you want to send screenshots for me to run on the stream, well, if it was done via tokens, there'd be a lot less of them, and you could sort of almost self-police them. So I wouldn't mind actually opening back up to screenshots again. So that would be one possibility. You could spend, I don't know, 60 tokens or something, some amount, and you could send me a screenshot, which I can add to the slideshow between the scenarios. Yeah, the brakes on this train are pretty fierce, so we're all right. We're all right. We're gone good time as well. Yes, it is the third night we've done a 155. In fact, there'll be another one. I think I'm going to do it on Monday for the last part. It's a series of scenarios. Another one I had an idea of was yeah, I know he does the competition things. That's ways of earning it. It's what you actually want to then. What are the rewards, as they call them, that you want? So sending a screenshot in. One of the ones I thought of was people have asked about doing TPTS a slightly, to Twitch Plays a slightly different way. What about if you could spend some number of tickets and have two or five minutes of dedicated control where it's just you exclusively driving the train? How would that sound? Or maybe even you spend quite a lot and you get dedicated control for the entire stream, for the entire Twitch Plays. That's what I want. There you go. Wipers are a bit faster now. Yep, GWR, I will do that. How will it not work, BMJ? How will it not work? On the car, good one. Looks like you've got some good routes there. Would you get horn control? Why not? Hey, Scorpion Ron, your profile is counting achievements as medals. Oh, I don't quite know what that would mean. Maybe you send me an email with a screenshot so I understand more. Maybe put a screenshot up to Imgur or something and paste it in the URL. Get one of the mods to approve you so you can paste a screenshot. Maybe if I see a screenshot I might understand it better. That won't be fair at all. How do you mean, Cameron's Gaming? It's only meant for, you know, for people who want to do it, and it will require quite a lot of tickets. It won't be something that everyone can just randomly do. How come the chat is not showing up? Twitch Alerts has got a problem by the looks of it. I'm going to have a look at it later on. See whether there's anything I can do to get it back. Well, I won't be doing all of them with like that BMJ, so some of them will be done with points bonuses and some of them won't. But that's valid feedback. Luca Watling, you love the stream? Awesome, thank you very much. I'm trying to work out what kind of things you guys want to see as rewards. Because if you don't want to see anything as rewards, there's not much point putting the system in. So... one other idea I had was what I'm calling Moggy Lock, which would mean that you'd be able to stop me from using the wipers for 2 minutes, for example. Or for those that get annoyed with about the American scenarios, you can do a horn be gone and stop me from using the horn for a couple of minutes. So, just trying to. I'm basically throwing ideas out. I want to see what you think, what your thoughts are. I've posted on Facebook about it. Go and find the post and respond, and let me know what your thoughts are. We'll put them in the chat for the time being. Well, you know, while we're here talking about it. Because I've got to write the bot to do this, so it's not going to be trivia to do that. But it's the sort of thing that if it's something you guys think would be fun and would add a little extra dimension to the stream, I'm up for it. Let's have a go. From a positive perspective, what it means for the stream, what these loyalty systems do is they encourage viewer retention. They encourage people to come along. Be more often there so that they can gain the points and so forth. So it means viewer numbers might be higher, and people might stay longer, be more interactive in chat. So that's kind of the stream goal for it. But what I'm trying to do is I'm not going to do it if it's not something that we're all thinking, hey, this could be really fun. Partly because of the work involved, and just partly because if we're not all on board and thinking it's a good idea, then let's just stick as we are. I don't want to just jump on every new trend that's going around on YouTube and Twitch. Luca, yes, this will be on Twitch, on YouTube, sorry, at some point. Right. Better. It wouldn't be a Twitch plays, more insert name here plays. Well, I guess one of the reasons I sort of had for that one was people were asking about teams. They were asking about individuals and so forth, and groups wanting to have a sort of a dedicated go at doing it. So this is sort of one option on that. Maybe we do them all as like, you know, we have two Twitch plays and one of them is allows for people to, you know, gain dedicated access. Maybe instead of just 5 minutes, it's 1 minute. And that way a number of people can request dedicated access in a single thing. I don't know, it's an idea. I'm trying to think of ways that are relevant. Different colours in the on-stream chat. Yeah, I don't know how that works. Everyone chooses their own colour, so I've got no idea how streamers control that. If you've got any information on that, I'll have a look. Can we just Moggy Lock now? No, because Moggy Lock, I haven't written it yet. Right, Eschenlo. Sixty limit again at the next signal. Would it be possible for different people in chat to play different roles? That's an interesting idea. Luca Watling, it's not a money-based thing, so you'll never be able to buy tickets with money. Yeah, you only get tickets by watching. Have we done a Hamburg Lübeck TPTS? I'm not sure. Probably not, actually. That might be a good idea. We haven't done much in the way of Germany on TPTS, which is a bad thing. Shazen, it was more like one ticket per minute. And I was thinking of doing things like, you know, for 20,000 tickets or something, I can send a free t-shirt. Things like, you know, right at the top end, some real things I could send potentially, although I'll wait a little bit until I see how the system goes before I start committing to doing anything like that. But yes, you know, swag could be a potential option. Apparently Twitch Alerts is back, is it? Doesn't look like it, not for me. The 100. Yeah, well, the idea of the ticket system is really is it's a way of saying thank you to those that stick around on the stream more, and giving them more things to do on the stream. Not taking away from the things that, you know, if you only jump into the stream occasionally. It doesn't really take away from that, because you can still watch the stream. It's just about adding more things that you can do, potentially. No, I'm not going to do a screen capture of the chat and overlay it. We'll wait and get Twitch alerts working again. It's not a money system, no. It's like a token system, essentially. The minute it's actually an actual money system, it then all becomes very serious and gambling, and everything's got real prices associated with it, and it becomes actually illegal in a number of cases. So it's definitely not going to have any. You're not going to be able to get tokens by spending money. Right, there's a Shinlo. Could do 20k tickets for getting mod. No, I think the idea is the mods have to be handpicked. All the moderators have to agree that they're happy with who is joining the system. Then, you know, they're people they're going to be able to work with and so forth. So it's the mod thing is separate. Well, GWR, that's not a bad shout. I mean, if I was able to distribute the client for it, then in theory I could do, you know, that multiplayer firing thing I did with Ed Fisk. I could have a thing that lets you control that, perhaps via the Twitch chat or via some other mechanism, so that you can see what is going on. And take over control of the firing or something. Be interesting. It's another good thought. You've said you've got 25 gold, 3 silver, and 2 bronze. That's interesting. Have you only completed 12 scenarios? Completed or attempted or won? What you can do is, if you go into your profile, there's a thing which has got your collection or something on it, and then you can, in there, you can, there's a button that flips all of them things over. It looks like the store, but it's the collection. And it'll tell you in each one of those how many gold, middle, silver and so forth you've done. Maybe you've done the same scenario multiple times and you've got a bronze one time, a gold, and a silver another time, and a gold another time. Might that sound reasonable, Scorpion Ron? Because that would show up as three separate medals. You've still earned the medal. Oh, it does say that. Oh, hang on, just because I'm in the chat. There we go. Random T's flying everywhere. Can you suggest scenarios of the ticket system? I was thinking of doing a thing whereby you'd have a higher priority for suggesting a scenario, or just saying I'd want something with this particular local or this particular route. I still use the spreadsheet because that's still valid, and I still get suggestions from that. Someone might say, pay, or might use a ticket, a bunch of tickets to say, I want to see the Acela Express, and then I'd look through the spreadsheet to work out an Acela Express scenario, for example. And it might be that you pay a lot of tickets and you can say, actually, I would like this scenario and I'd like it next week, please. Oh, that's interesting, Scorpio Ron. Interesting indeed. Have you emailed the support people? Gone to dovetailgames.kayako.com, I think it is. Team Monster, thank you for the follow. Much appreciated. Unfortunately, Twitch Alerts is being twitchy, so it's not working very well. Let me just try turning it back on again. All right, everyone start chatting in chat. Let's see if anything appears. No, it's not. It's still got the error. Yeah, TSL t-shirts, TSL caps. I can come up with something like that for sort of the high end of the rewards. But what I was looking for is the sort of what sort of stream interactions would you like to see? Uh, 5029. I've only got access to things that are on Steam. If they've never been on Steam, then I don't have them. Pen Dennis, no, I haven't thought about a giveaway yet, to be honest. I've just been too busy. I'm glad you said it, 5029. I'm glad you said it. A free TSL train or skin for a train sim. Yeah, I haven't got any of that sort of stuff. I might have a look and see if I can do that, but... Trainmaster, the chat's not working tonight on the stream. But it's another good idea. Spin Josh. How do you mean no more Twitch based train sim? We're doing that next. At the moment, I'm drinking Diet Coke. I'm slumming it. Partly because I'm afraid of looking at my mug and I think it's going to take revenge on me if I don't get it in the wash soon. Yeah, imagine when YouTube sees this one, they'll be, the YouTube viewers will be looking at it going, oh, finally, you got rid of that on screen chat. Is there anything new coming to TPTS? So what would you like? So what's with the suggestions? I'm looking at implementing a reward system, like a loyalty bot. And I'm wanting to know what rewards you'd like. What kind of ideas have you got for rewards that you could spend tickets on? Viewers pretty low tonight. Yeah, we're only up just up to 99. But it's Thursday, so squirrel streaming. And Thursday, Friday are always hard going for viewers. If we don't average more than 100, it'll be the first time in, I don't know, several weeks actually that we don't, which will be a gut punch, to be honest, towards getting the partnership. Yes, it'll be a custom bot that I'm writing, Flying Scotsman. Right. Murnau. Where are we going? Oops, hello. That's not what I wanted to do. Murnau. All the way to Starnberg. Oh, 106 now. Keep it coming, folks. Pass the message. Get more people watching the stream. James Class 37, does it make you a bad person if they say you don't like tea? It just means that you haven't grown to like tea yet, that's all it means. It means that in your future, you could yet learn to like tea. I'm not sure what to suggest about that Scorpio, Ron. It's not something I'd notice, but I must admit I don't really look at that screen all that much. I'll have to, if you raise it, if send a ticket to the Dovetail support system, dovetailgames.keiko.com, and, God, my throat tonight, and I'll raise it, I'll have a chat with them. See if it's something they're aware of. About to climb quite a steep hill here. If you guys aren't aware, there was a patch went out this morning, which is why your background on the game is reset, unfortunately, that fixes the workshop upload issue. So if you're finding that when you upload scenarios, you get it just sits there hung, sitting there saying, saying verifying or validating, that is the bug that's now been fixed. So try you uploading your workshop scenarios again, you should be all good. And if you're not, raise a ticket. Symptoms of Diet Coke instead of tea, yeah, possibly. Anything is possible. Fifty at the next signal. Right, we're just under 50 now. Right, 50 through this signal. Right, coming into Murnau now. That'd be the reason for the 50 then, if we're swinging over this way. Spin Josh. So the thing in the bottom left corner with the satellite map is a tool that I've written. Unfortunately, I can't distribute it, but there is another one on the internet you can download that somebody else did after they saw mine, and I showed them how to do it. If someone can do the follow map, there you go, Moggy's done the follow map command. So that's not the same one I use, but it does essentially the same job. And I like Windows 10. I really like Windows 10. I get no complaints from me about it. No, you're not just a pretty face, Moggy. Fortunate, really. Nope. Stuff I'll see. Limit as we pull out of here. There you go, I've just insulted Moggy and the viewer numbers are going up. Right, in that case I know exactly what to do. Brace yourself, Moggy! I upgraded to Windows 10 as soon as it came out. It came out on my birthday. What is it? Over a year ago now. I always get to this, go through the latest version of Windows because it's where everything's at. But I happen to like Windows 10. I like it a lot. And I've got Forza Horizon 3 as well. What's wrong with the title, Spin Josh? Yeah, I think I need a cup of tea, don't I? What's the situation with this? Ooh, that looks really nasty. You forgot to add the player train runner gaming? Well, that'll be a problem. That'll be a problem. .4072. Good, you're enjoying that. You got what you needed out of that video. That's good to know. Excluding Windows Vista, yes, Trainmaster. Windows Vista was a travesty, although I did use Windows Vista as well. But Windows Vista was a travesty. Yeah, can one of the moderators... Oh, in fact, Moggy has just done. Moggy's just done it. Moggy's not just a pretty face, is he? He's just genuinely awesome. Oops, better stop complimenting Moggy. The viewers will go away. Yeah, Vista did settle down Crucible, but I wasn't a fan. And I'm generally quite tolerant of Windows releases. I got on alright with Windows 8, for example. I have a pretty good problem with Windows 8. Will TSY really work with Windows 7? I don't know, actually. I need to make sure that that gets tested. I can't think of a reason why it wouldn't, but... There's no rush, we're a minute ahead of schedule. It's raining on TPTS as well, and bad fog. Yeah, I haven't done much with the B1 revarnish. Maybe it's an opportunity for you to knock up an awesome scenario. is definitely better of the 8 releases, yeah, absolutely. Windows Vista plus MSTS equal to edit. At least it worked. Does MSTS even work on Windows 10? I don't even know whether that works. I imagine there's no reason why it wouldn't, to be honest. Is there any reason why these German trains use throttle wheels instead of levers? I must admit, I don't know what the origin is and why they've gone for the throttle, the turn throttle. Oh, I really don't know why that is. Windows ME, now that was the worst of the old kernel. Windows 98 SE was the best of that kernel, and then they ruined it, Windows ME. Spinge off, yeah, Forza Horizon 3 isn't bad. There's a few things they haven't quite got right with it. I need to run the latest version, the latest update, because they've apparently fixed G27 support now. Will Minion45, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. Apologies, the overlay isn't working for reasons of Twitch alerts. But a humbug. Yeah, I've seen ATMs doing NT4 blue screen and deaths. One outside Stratford Station did that on more than one occasion. Arnold Strimmer, good evening everyone. And Matt, how's everyone doing? Apologies for the... Thank you very much for the donation, Arnold. But apologies, the overlay isn't working because Twitch alerts have been twitchy. So yeah, very big thank you to Arnold for that donation. Need tea. Right, what speed limit of 140? Hey, Badaraki, welcome. I need water. Now, I've tried that and it never really helps. Once my... Brakes are less effective at speeds above 125 km/h. Well, let's keep it below that then, shall we? Oops. You hear the calling of the kettle, yeah. No, 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 I want to get that played tomorrow. I'm excited to play it. That's a good point, Morbs. If you've got trains, says if you've got trains with 39 notches, which is when the, with this the BR103 does. This one's got 30. Then a wheel is really the only way, and you can have a that you can have a positive feel with each notch. Otherwise, you'd have a really, really long throttle lever or tiny movements. Yeah, everyone's telling me I need a cup of tea. I will make a cup of tea in a minute. Unfortunately, my mug is dirty. Like, it's got half of the last cup of tea in it, so I can't... I've got no way of making a cup of tea right now, which is a pretty sad situation. Have to wait till the end of this scenario. That's the other question, is it why have you got 30 notches? Yeah, my throat isn't sore, Cameron's Gaming. It's not even remotely sore, it just feels like it's blocked up. Acknowledgement. 60 limit of the next signal. Down to 75. Do I watch The Simpsons? I used to watch The Simpsons. Back when it was the new and cool thing to watch. Coming into Hoofing. Your stream is turned off. Sending that, is that okay for everybody else? I guess otherwise I'll be seeing lots of rips and flame baskets. Sherman Hill Hera TPTS with her heritage. Yeah, the only reason I don't normally do American Freight TPTS is because really TPTS, I think, it sort of shines when you've got to start and stop the train numerous times, and you don't really have that with American Freight. uh, And bear in mind that, you know, if you're going down a hill, I guess the American brakes are a bit harder to use, but we could try one and see how it goes, see what people think about it. Wilhelm Oberbay. Sixty limit as we come out of here. Nimmy voice, Twitch alerts are having a problem tonight, so I will get the. I'm gonna have a quick look at Twitch alerts after this scenario, and after I've got a mug for a cup of tea, and. Yeah, well, I'll see if there's anything I can do to get it working. Badaraki, Subnautica streams. I was going to go back and do Subnautica once I've got partners. Because it doesn't really get very many views. If I do it now, then it'll just make it take a lot longer to get partners. What 30-year NSC screenshot competition, James Class 37? Ribku's Twitch lights are working fine, are they? It might be that I need to go on and reset something then. Most challenging train to dive is the FEF3 for Steam in advanced mode, or any German train when driven with PZB on. Is it Pink Month this month, is it B. Harrison? Awesome. The best kind of month. Southern Pacific fan, why did they remove the EMD SD60? I mean, the SD60M, how do you mean remove it? It was bundled as it's part of Sherman Hill now. It's a free part of Sherman Hill, but I think. Hey Ruben, welcome back, sir. Will I be designing emojis for custom subscribers? Yes, I will. In fact, I already spoke to one of my artist friends today, and he is more than happy to design some emoticons. So if the question is, will I be doing it? No. I'll be specking them out, but I won't be doing it. I've got speaking to a very good artist, he will be doing it. Hey Flames167, welcome. We're up to Wilhelm Oberbay. We're not that many at all to go now. 4 or 5, 3.4 kilometres. Lick Lord Kurz, when someone uploads to Steam Workshop, all the tagging is done automatically. It's all done based on what it detects as the dependencies. On a Nebworth con. You want me to make it sound like, so I sound like a chipmunk? No. I don't think I can even do that with the sound card I'm using through the microphone now. Ooh, we've got an expect reduced speed coming up. Reduced to 60. Race hype. Let's drop it to the 75. When you search routes, nothing shows up. Yeah, sometimes the searching through particular tags is a little bit hit and miss, and sometimes when you do a search, Steam says there are no results, and if you just right click and press refresh, all of a sudden results will appear. And sometimes you need to do that 6 or 7 times before results will appear, for reasons of Steam. You want me to talk just high pitch there, David? Apparently that changes my accent as well. My accent? Yeah, my accent is an accident, but... Oh, V200. Flames, no, we're not doing trucks tonight. Oh, we're in restricted speed, speed restriction because we came in with 100 hertz and it's had to, 1000 hertz and had to stop. Yeah, it's the German warship that you can hear. Look over this side, there it is. Look. Trains have FM radios or drivers MP3 players. I don't think they're allowed to listen to music while they're driving because they've got audible alarms they need to be listened to. There certainly aren't radios in the cabs as far as I'm aware. There are train radios, and again they have to be able to listen out for those. Would having virtual machines watch the stream help you to get partnered? No, it would get me banned off Twitch. That's called view botting, and it's highly against their rules. And just generally a nonsensical idea, because there's no point falsely bumping up your numbers. You lost 14 hours of work, it took you 2 hours to replace. Yeah, I find that quite commonly. You'll lose a ton of work, and you'll go back and do it again, and it won't take you anywhere near as long. Which, on the one hand, you're relieved because it isn't going to take as long, and on the other hand, you're thinking, it took me so long the last time. And then every time you do something from then on, you're thinking, but if I do this again, it'll take me so much less time. Which is obvious when you think about it, but it doesn't stop you feeling bad that you're pre-wasting time. What's happened to the background of TS? I think there's a bug at the moment, Nimmy Boy. It's not a bug with the game so much as a bug with one of the CMS servers. But I gather they're on it and they're going to get it fixed. Yes, I did DWR and I did answer it earlier on. And yeah, the access to the multiplayer thing would be... would be one more interesting possible use for it. Right, we've got reduced speed 60 at this point. We're currently in restricted monitoring. Right, we've come out of restrictive monitoring, so we can now push to 60. 29 minutes is around about the top end. You don't really want to go anywhere beyond half an hour. Normally it's about 20 minutes for TPTS. But if it's up 20 to 30 is about spot on. Oh, Arnold, the mile 2 error is fixed. It is fixed as of today, I think, or yesterday. Northeast Corridor, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. Apologies that the stream overlay isn't working. I think I need to jump onto each other's website and re-authenticate or something. Badaraki, what games am I going to play afterwards? Well, I'm going to get back to doing trucking at some point very soon. I'm kind of missing it. And City Skylines, Forza Horizon 3 if people want to see it. There's a couple of new games that, like the Giant Machines one and the one that Squirrel just did a demo of today. That's a possible for the future, I guess. That could, was it Build and Destroy Simulator or something? Is that the one you're talking about, B. Harrison? Yeah, the one that Squirrel's done a little preview of. Looks interesting, actually. It looks quite. It looks fun. It's nothing too deep, but it looks fun. Have I done a shunting? Yes, I have. If you have a look, and you should see I've done the shunting one. Wilshofen. How long till the scenario ends? Got Tutzing, Fidelfing, Felderfing, Hossenhofen, and Starnberg. 22 kilometres. Which is due in 28 minutes. Why are there no UK roofs tonight? Well, I am going to show the new BR TPO pack, so that's a UK thing. But because I started late and because I need to get some more work done on the stream, the YouTube channel tonight, before I go to bed, and because I didn't go to bed till almost 2 this morning, I don't want to stream too late tonight. So, and the scenario I had lined up for tonight was 80 minutes long, so I had to move it to tomorrow. Given I was already late, I didn't have time to find a different scenario to put in, so that's fine. I think the tutorial might run over a bit, and the and so forth. So, some more farming sim. Yes, definitely. I want to do some more farming sim. I haven't done anything of that for quite a while. See you later, Chris. You caused the AI to switch into your track and it hit you. Well, that's not very clever, is it? I think we're just about. I think it's just about all UK tomorrow. So, where you're not getting much UK today, you're going to get just about all UK tomorrow. How long is left in the scenario? About 25 minutes. Is farming sim mostly crops and muck spreading? Yeah, pretty much, that's it. You can do mowing of lawns, but that's pretty much the same as crops. Grass is just a crop. Hey, Webbs Racing, I'm doing good, thank you. GWR, if you look on the schedule, I've already got tomorrow planned. But I'll try and get yours in next week. I'll do both of them, part 2 and 3. Still not 100%, still coughing lots. Have you been to see a doctor, B. Harrison? If you're coughing more than a certain amount of time, they recommend you should go and see the doc. No, TPTS will not crash into Hoboken because you are starting from Hoboken. Yeah, the Fahrmotor Lufter is on. I'll have to have a look and see what other scenarios Purno has done, because these aren't bad at all. There's plenty of AI in them. They're a sensible challenge. Halloween TPTS. Yeah, well, maybe we could do a Halloween camp with Monster Disco. I'll have to have a look and see what we can do with that. Well, this race is only going to go so far, isn't it? Given that I've got a stop in 1.5 kilometres. German dub of Still Alive. Ah, Portal for the win. Purno's always been a content creation from way back, so many mods for locomotion. Nice. Well, I'm going to do Count the Monster Disco primarily, eh, Rubin? But what I want to do is have a look and see how much time that will take, and then potentially do some Trains vs. Zombies as well. Because I've not played through the original Trains vs. Zombies yet. Go up to the end. Hey, Southern Pacific fan, thanks for joining. Yeah, it's another 155. He thinks he's better than me. I suspect I'm crossing. No, if you look at the track work, I'm going to. I've got permission. I've got the right of way in front of him, so there won't be a continuation. We'll have to wait for it to be fixed. How do you mean, Arnold? What's wrong? Right, so green light and off. Fell duffing. A Galesburg Zephyr scenario with 765. Nice. Arnold A. Schrimmer, BR155 is part of Cologne Koblenz. That's where it's been bundled into. So if you own Cologne Koblenz, you've already got the 155. If you don't own the Cologne Koblenz, then you, if you buy Cologne Koblenz, it now comes with the 155. I think the store pages for that's been updated to say that, if you want to just confirm. It's like the turbine has been bundled in as part of the Sherman Hill route. Says FML, it's for motor lüfter, which is the motor blowers. If it was flashing FML, then that might be that might be different. Well, there's a spare hole there, so you can put a smiley face on that one, so you can do FML smiley face. Cologne Koblenz was one of the TS16 routes, David, yes. Suddenly realizing he's got to stop here. Thanks the great brakes on the BR155 profusely. Is it possible a route in TS to have broken sounds? I'm not quite sure what you're asking, B. Harrison. Can I use your face as a mask for Halloween? No, I don't think that's appropriate. I mean, there's the scary and then there's, you know, my face. You get asked to never come back again. That's what I find anyway. When I go places, I get asked to never come back again. Ooh, I wonder if there's a voice modifier VST plugin. Interesting. Is the weather cold over there? It's getting cold, yes. It's cooler. I mean, at the moment it's still in, I think, generally it's still in double figures, but it's definitely got an edge to it now. That laugh is creepy. Yeah, I know. I used to scare the living daylights out of my daughter. One of the things that, you know, she was sitting there playing in the bath and I'd just peek around the door. And she'd look up at me with a panicked look on her face and say, "Stop it! Stop it!" I'm dad of the year. See you later, eh, Ruben? Possenhofen. It's Ayrton. Welcome, sir. Alright, thanks, Chris. The echo thing is, if you look under the options for sound, it's a thing is called EFX. If you look for the EFX option, make sure you've got that turned on. It used to be that the EFX would only work if you had an EAX enabled sound card, which was quite expensive at the time. There was Creative Labs top end cards. But when the game switched over to OpenAL, the audio library, in 2013, that EFX option became available for everybody because it's all done on software now instead of hardware. So if you just turn that option on, you'll get all the echo and so forth. And this scenario hasn't got much longer now. About 15 minutes, I would suggest. It's quite a long scenario. It's an 80-minute scenario. Bob, we have two daughters and used to wind them up all the time. Now they're older, they're getting their own back. I know. And my daughter's going to be a cracker for that. I just know it. I'm getting pre-revenging. That's what I'm calling it. See how web tracing? No problem at all. Yeah, well, it's Friday, so we can stay up a bit later and we can have some fun. And yes, I did. Started 8:30 tonight. So that James Class 37. Would everyone please hurry up and get on? Thank you. Starnberg, that's our final stop. I think. I do believe. Absolutely. In that case, 5 minutes to go. 120 limit. Yeah, about 5 or 6 minutes till TPTS, folks. About 5 or 6 minutes. James 131. So yeah, I've access to all of the Dovetail stuff on Steam, and all the third party stuff that's on Steam. And whether anyone else chooses to send me their stuff is entirely up to them. But I don't really install anybody else's or run it on here normally. I've had a couple of people on here previously for to help somebody get some answer, either to answer a question. If they've got a question, they'll send it to me so I can take a look, or to help set something else up, like the rail driver for them. But for the most part, I just stick to running the dovetail stuff, because that's what I want to show off. That's fine, Arnold. I remember you telling me about that. That's absolutely fine. My favourite UK train? I'm not sure. So many trains that I really like driving. It's as much down to what you're doing with the train. I mean, steam engines, I can pretty much take them doing anything just about, because you've got a lot to look after with the locomotive anyway. Like electric, like say a 319 or something like that, I enjoy driving that as long as it's got lots of station stops. If it's an express service, London to Peterborough, and you're not stopping at all, I find that quite tedious, if I'm honest. But if it's London to Peterborough, stopping at every station along the way, that's pretty cool, because you're constantly driving the train. Hey, train boy, welcome. Yeah, the APTE would be cool, wouldn't it? Right, we've got a yellow signal coming up. Do I like driving the Invincible? Yeah, Invincible was good fun to drive. It's not at the top of my list of favourite steam locos to drive in the game, but it's definitely up there. The limit, just cruising back up to the 60, and then we'll pull into Starnberg. Or the prototype HST, that'd be cool too. See you in a minute, Nimmy boy. It's almost Twitch Place train sim time, folks. Realised at the last minute we've gone through the 500 Hz magnet. So, door is open. Lol, Kev. Lol. Muggy's warming up the naughty step, is he? Excellent. Is the wheel the brake? No, the wheel is the throttle, James. I love the paces. I do like the paces. There it looks. More like the right shape now. You've reached your final destination for this journey. Let's see how you did.